the power to take him off the bench. I mean, he has contact with the trainer, and that guy has to go to the quiet room. Here's Mott, who scores. Second goal of the game for Tyler Mott. Well, you see the breakaway speed of Tyler Mott. Mike Kitchen alluded to that. Watch the play here by Marcus Kruger, Pat. Kruger's going to come into your picture and see him knock the stick down of Kevin Shattenkirk. And Tyler Mott goes 5-0. Watch 16 in red. Take the stick away and interfere with Kevin Shattenkirk.
Puck cleared up the boards, and now a lead pass. Here's a breakaway chance for the Hawks, and an open net. Great move by Alexander Fortan, the only Blackhawk player who will have appeared in all four games in five nights. And the 19-year-old didn't look too tired there, did he? What a beautiful play out of the zone. Spencer Abbott.
Branson checked. Here's DeClaire trying to get loose. Anthony DeClaire deeks. He scores.
Boy,
beautiful move. Forehand, backhand to forehand, and Markstrom might be shaken up.
Well, at full speed, Anthony DeClaire gets by a little miscommunication at the blue line for the Canucks. There, good Branson and Nikita Trampkin. And DeClaire's off to the races. Boy, at top speed with Trampkin trying to chase him down. That's good. Branson, Trampkin is trying to chase DeClaire down. No contest in that race, but you see DeClaire, when he is tripped up, the skates come right into Jacob Markstrom.
Read his lips. First thing he said was, "Are you okay?"
Yes.
As the puck went in, he turned immediately to the Canuck goaltender and said, "Are you okay?" Which apparently he is, but that could have been worse.
Oh.
Control. Stewart, long pass for Lowry. Lowry sends it through for Tanev. Scores! Brandon Tanev slips it through the pads of Cam Talbot, and the Jets are on the board. It's 2-1.
And Gustafson's coming back on the ice, just not soon enough for Cam Talbot. It's Brandon Tanev able to score a goal. Boy, tough coach. You get scored on, you're done. Anyways, Brandon Tanev able to sneak behind everybody, but it's a great play. Starts with Stewart. Tanev starts it, drops it for Stewart. Great cross-ice feed to Lowry. And Lowry's just going to chip this pass. Tanev continues, gets behind everyone. And a great move as he opens up the pads and beats Talbot 5-0. And the Jets cut the lead in half.
On Saturday, Jets riding a four-game point streak. Shorthanded, Letestu scores! Another turnover and another shorthanded goal.
The Oilers have made the adjustment. They got lit up by the Jets' power play in Winnipeg for four power play goals by Winnipeg, and now it's the shorthanded version. And again, Bufflin, this pass is going to get picked off. Great read by Pouliot. He finds Letestu. Letestu in alone, and he beats Hellebuck to the glove side. That play is just right. We saw Morrissey give one up like that, so said there's no pre-scout. It looks like the Oilers know the breakout.
Got as the stick snaps. Now a chance shorthanded after Myers breaks the stick, scores. Shorthanded goal for Connor McDavid.
Not the guy you want your stick to break and come back at you full speed. Is a bad break for Tyler Myers, who gets the puck right where they want. Quick puck movement. It's going to come down the line. A right back. Perfect shot. Net presence. And the stick snaps in half. And then chipped in. Connor McDavid coming in all alone. And just a little chip play as he gets that pass. Connor Hellebuck. I'm not sure how much room he had. And he finds a way to score. His second of the game.
Across the goal mouth, Reed had a gaping net. But if he'd been a left shot, here's Spooner on a breakaway with the game on his stick. He scores! Ryan Spooner sticks a fork in him.
Well, there's your third star tonight. Nice lead pass by David Backes. This is what three-on-three is designed to do. Opportunities at both ends, wide open hockey, the skill guys on the ice, the speed guys. And Backes makes a nice little outlet pass, really get caught, a little too deep. Not only a clean breakaway for Spoon.
It's Sakura who lugs the puck to center. Monahan killing the penalty, along with Brower, who just stole the puck. Troy Brower, shorthanded, scores! First is a flame, shorthanded, it's a one-goal game.
Jim, a coach's nightmare. I mean, you draw up power play breakouts, but usually you have to react to where the pressure's coming. Look at the two forwards down low in Everly and McDavid. But for Leon Draisaitl, the one thing you can't do is a risky backhand pass. If it's not there, you can't try to force it. Everly gets himself in no man's land, gets beat to the outside. And how about Brower? Head up the entire way, a little pump fake there. And Talbot was down early, and Brower making an early impact.
Turned it over, then got it back. Here's a pass for Cassian. He's in alone. Deeks scores! Calgary caught on a change. McDavid and Cassian make them pay. 3-1 Oilers.
You look at the top of your screen. Everybody going to the bench a little bit late, developing, and a heads-up play by McDavid. Instead of allowing that puck to go up, he just kicked it back to his D-man, and a heads-up pass there by Clefbaum, tape to tape. And despite a rolling puck, you can see Cassian, he just controlled it for a split second, showed a lot of patience there and curling it back around and getting it underneath Brian Elliott, who five shots on goal, three of them have fouled in the back of the net.
Brandon Carlo playing his NHL debut. Marchand blocks the pass. Backes to Pasternak, all the way in. Rebound. Marchand scores! The Bruins have come from two down, and now they lead with 10:06 to go. Brad Marchand with a tremendous night.
Well, David Savard, the right defenseman for Columbus, pinches down in the offensive zone and forces this errant play by Boston, but then all of a sudden the recovery by Marchand frees the puck up. Backes is able to recognize Pasternak's off ice. He lets him skate into a pass in order to get in on a breakaway. He tries to hold it, go backhand forehand, and then slide it through the legs or back against the grain.
To the front of the net, instead to the point. Spezza, the forward, turns it over. Shorthanded breakaway for Andrew Cogliano. He's in, got his own rebound, and scored. What did I just say?
A great play by Cogliano, and he follows his rebound to the net. Almost passes it off the goaltender's pads to himself. This is a huge goal for the Ducks. Active stick, the speed of Cogliano. Spezza gives it away.
Miami was in great position. The goaltender gets a little bit unlucky because that rebound, when it's 3 feet out in front of your pad, you know you're in trouble because the player has room to just chip it up over top. Huge goal for Cogliano in the Ducks.
Blocked bravely in front of the goal by Chris Russell. Who else? And here goes McDavid. On a break. McDavid scores. Connor McDavid turns on the Jets. And the Oilers tie the game at one.
Awareness. You have to know when Connor McDavid is on the ice and there's that blazing speed. And the shot block led to that opportunity by McDavid.
and Jordan Eberle quickly recognized McDavid was away. And similar to the penalty shot in Edmonton on Wednesday, although that went to the forehand, but when he goes to the backhand, he's able to elevate that just over the pad of Brian Elliott, and not many people can do that at speed. And that is perfectly placed about 18 inches off the ice and off the post and in.
Goal. Wyman chasing the puck, trying to get it back to Brody, stolen by Letestu with some room. Letestu, shorthanded, scores! Flames had two shorthanded goals on Wednesday. Letestu answers back with one tonight for the Oilers, and they take a 4-2 lead.
And that's a fifth breakaway given up by the Flames. Letestu with a good stick in his own zone leads to this shorthanded attempt. And what's going to be noticeable is that this does not go directly in. In fact, it hits the goalpost and bounces back out and then off the right skate of Brian Elliott and into the net. And so the Oilers get a break on that one, but give Letestu lots of credit for a really good stick.
You hold on to it too long, you're going to play slow.
Here's a breakaway, speaking of fast, Tarasenko checks, he scores!
Well, you talk about moving the puck quickly. In the middle of the ice, it didn't take long for that puck to get up to Vladdy Tarasenko. Three goals against the New York Rangers in his career. And this one here with speed, I had a good angle of it. He loves going to that stick side if it's available. And it doesn't take him long to get that from his stick blade to the middle of the blade, and then bang!
Opening night game for the Avalanche. Great pass. Here's a chance. Go! Peter, that is a perfect example of what the Avs want to do in terms of that big long pass, correct?
Well, Mike, we saw in the first period with Jerome Iginla. Jerome Iginla broke up the ice and got it. If the puck was bouncing, unfortunately. But what a pass, right on the tape. And Soderberg makes no mistake. Soderberg came over from the Boston Bruins as a free agent last year. What an absolutely perfect, perfect play for the Avalanche. And again, this place is rumbling.
It's a carryover, so there's still a minute 7 left in time. Here's a steal, Richardson, and he skates in and he scores! A shorthanded goal! Brad Richardson, 3-1 Coyotes!
Well, this all starts because of the pressure put on by Jordan Martinuk right there on the sideboards. He was given a gift. He leaves a little poker there to Richardson, who finds the back of the net on Mason. Low to the blocker side. Beautiful pass by Martinuk. And nice finish there by Richardson. A shorty. A power play now, a shorthanded goal. Perfectly placed shot.
The center and into the Red Wing zone for Cece. Knocked away. Zetterberg turns, ooh, waiting for a change. Ooh. But first will make a pass to Helm, who's in the clear, ready to go. Scores!
Right on the tape. And we talk about passes being important. Well, if he has to wait, he can't get a breakaway and score a goal. It was on the tape. He doesn't break stride. Beautiful float pass by Zetterberg with some zip on it, up over the sticks and skates, right onto the tape of Darren Helm. And he gets number 2 on the year. Makes no mistake.
By Hayes, and that didn't get to the net. Bernistra.
Great feed from Bermeister.
Dextroff. No communication by the Bruins that the penalty was over. Turnover for Dextroff. Miller doesn't adjust. No one does as Wheeler comes in all alone. And what a move. This time he gets Rask to wobble and fall as he digs him out and puts this home. A nice move as Wheeler, his third of the season.
You go back to last year, and Blake Wheeler has now scored in 9-8 straight games.
10.
The third goaltender for Arizona would be Justin Peters. He played.
Now a steal by Kelly, walks in, shoots, scores! That one's in, and it's 4-2 Ottawa.
Well, welcome to the game, Louis Domingue.
It's been a long time for Chris Kelly as a laugh as he just rang one shot off of two goal posts. Puck turned over badly here by Martin Hanzel. Kelly intercepts it. Domingue, who hasn't even broken a sweat yet, gets beat on the first shot. The Coyotes, who'd made it 3-2, now trail by a couple as Ottawa responds again.
Avalanche 2-for-2 killing penalties in this first period. And a steal by Duchesne, he's got a chance, shot, pad save, rebound, score! Matt Duchesne with his first point of the season and a big goal for the Avalanche, and the Avs lead 1-0 on that second effort from Matt Duchesne.
How many big things happen over the course of the last 30 seconds? The Avalanche do a great job killing off the penalty. So all of a sudden that's done, something that's been really a troublesome spot for them, and then Duchesne picks it up, comes in, gets his own rebound, and he gets his first of the season. And there's, when you're a goal scorer, when you're a kind of player that Matt Duchesne is, boy, that the weight's off now. The weight is off, and he can just start to relax a little bit. And he just stayed with that great pickup on that rebound.
On to a career with the Wisconsin Badgers before joining the Maple Leafs. Coyle has Staal. Staal's in alone. He scores! Make it 1-for-9 on the breakaway for Minnesota.
You can only hope to contain him? Is that what we're saying now? The Wild have had, as we spoke about, many breakaways. And this one is one that you can put into the goal ledger. A lot of patience and just finds a spot. Picks his head up and looks for the crook of the arm, because that's where he went, right underneath the blocker.
Where you can just feel how big the next goal is going to be in this game. And that's why I say Carolina has to continue to attack and really feel the importance of that third goal.
Stretch pass. Here comes Staalberg in for a chance. He scores! Victor Staalberg with his first as a Hurricane. Carolina is up by 3.
Well, you ask and you shall receive. Watch this beautiful pass to Staalberg coming across behind the Calgary defense, staying on sides. Beautifully done, executed on the tape, staying on sides as Victor Staalberg. Power move to the backhand, and one of the many reasons that the next goal that now Carolina has, Stahlberg's first as a Hurricane, is so big off the post and in.
Fiala lost it. The Penguins go right back the other way. They got a man wide open. Wilson to the goal. He scores! And a loud ovation from the Penguin fans in the building here tonight as the Penguins virtually had a 2-on-0 there, and Wilson able to cash in to make it 1-0.
What a terrible play by Matthias Ekholm and a great play by Hornquist. Ekholm is going to decide to step here in the neutral zone, step up, but there is the stick of, yes, Patrick Hornquist. Wilson flying through the five hole of Soros, and Soros, you have met the Penguins and they're 2-on-0. What a tough start for this Nashville hockey team, but a terrible decision in the neutral zone, certainly for the defenseman.
Here's Colburn, centering feet, tipped away, and here comes Marchessault, trying to beat Beauchemin. Marchessault is in, and he hits the post!
No,
he
scores! It's
Marchessault! He does it again! His third!
That was deep, deep, deep. And again, it came out real hard because of the metal at the back of the net. That was no doubt. You saw the referee
Frederick Lecuyer right in there pointing, no doubt about it. Third goal of the season. What a play in that, again, anticipation. And now he's got time to think, time to look, and he finds the open spot.
Panthers management targeted Jonathan Marchessault in free agency. At every level, he has been a point.
2 minutes to go. His goalie's still in. They're down by two.
Point holding things up. Here's Feltola. He's on a break on Anderson. Fake shoot, scores! Valtteri Feltola makes it 4-1.
Ottawa was collapsed all over on the near side. Feltola came off the bench, and Brayden Point was smart enough to find him on the far side, and he was wide open. Point just throws it to an open area. Feltola controlling the puck, makes one nice move. Beautiful backhand to the forehand, moving from his right to left, gets Anderson protecting that five hole, and then throws it right upstairs.
Throw to the blue line. Buffalo can't see the net. Shifley takes over. Wheeler, good stick by Mark Letestu, and he's got a breakaway. Mark Letestu, shorthanded, scores! It was his play all the way. Poked the puck loose, beat Dustin Byfuglien, 1-0 Edmonton.
Those split-second decisions, and watch this for Dustin Byfuglien. He thought that Letestu was going to dive for that. And when he didn't, instead the puck wasn't there. Byfuglien thought it was going to be moving, and just a heads-up play. Letestu, once he did get control of the puck right there, got his speed. Look at his legs moving. Now he gets his head up, and that speed pushed the goaltender Hellebuyck back in his crease. He was already about a foot back on his blue, and that quick move just beat him up and over the glove.
For the Albertan Mark Letestu, that's his eighth career shorthanded goal, his second of this season, and it's a 1-0 lead for the Oilers.
Back in. Pass back. Ducks got their signals crossed. Here's a lead feed. Bo Horvat, shorthanded, in, scores! Bo Horvat on a breakaway. Shorthanded goal, and the game is tied at one.
John, we were talking about other things that Louis Erickson does. One of the things that he does is kill penalties. And Louis Erickson makes a nice one-handed pass, spots Bo Horvat, and just scoops it to him. And that leads Horvat on the breakaway. Blocker side. And beat Sean Gibson against the flow of this first period. A shorthanded goal for the Vancouver Canucks, their first of the season.
Get home for a day off before coming here.
Look out here.
He passed to Larkin. He's in the clear. Dylan Larkin scores!
Oh, there goes the piano.
Dylan Larkin bobblehead night.
What a great feed by Zetterberg. He's been winding her up here for the first 12 minutes. Over the pad, under the glove, and Larkin gets his first of the year. He was gone. Man, no way they're catching him. Nice move, quick to the backhand. There's another end zone look at it. Beautiful look. Way to go, guys. And it's 2-0 for the home team.
Forsberg trying to reverse it. Theodore pounces. Hard off the wall to the line. Broken up by Pagliano. Shorthanded breakaway. In on Mazanin. Score!
Well, we have seen this act before with Andrew Pagliano. But Kessler was trapped on the ice. He was dying out there. And the Preds mishandled the puck at the blue line. And Pagliano, boy, with that great stick, gets away from Ekholm and just opens up Mazanets wide. Moves that puck about 4 feet, and look at how far apart the legs are.
Gives to Suter. And now Stewart ahead for Zucker. Zucker in the low. He scores!
A breakaway that Zucker earned all the way through that shift. He made a good perimeter play that just didn't work on an attempted wraparound, but he came back, regrouped, good eyes by Stewart, and Zucker this time puts it home on a move that goes over the glove on the backhand. Zucker seems to have had breakaway after breakaway.
Long pass. Zuccarello breaks it onside. He scores! Matt Zuccarello does it again.
Sam, he knocked this one out of midair. This was a 120-foot pass from Ryan McDonough that was elevated. McDonough, low left side of your screen. Here it is. He knocks it down. It was 2 feet in the air and all in one motion. I mean, that is some kind of athleticism. Knocks it down, hardly breaks stride on the stick. Quick shot underneath the goaltender. Boy, oh boy, is Matt Zuccarello playing some kind of a hockey game here. Second goal of the night to tie it.
Oilers here in the second. Lucic to McDavid, right up the middle, in on goal, and is in. Miller got most of it, but his momentum pushed him backwards, and the puck went over the line, and Connor McDavid has made it 1-0.
Anton Lander taking the draw, and Brandon Sutter. And Connor McDavid takes off right away. He just jumps in, and he's the winger win, and now Gudbranson and Hutton. You can't have that kind of room. We talked about it before when McDavid fed it off. This time he's right up the middle. And five ball through Ryan Miller. Very McDavid, the speed. By Ben Hutton, still in control, protecting the puck. A beautiful move.
Fifth goal, 12 point.
Colorado assistant, who was an assistant in Anaheim with Ron Wilson way back in the inaugural days. Here's a chance. Reeder is in, and he scores! Toby Reeder. It's a one-goal game with 4:04 remaining. And here we go.
Watch this pass by Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Tobias Reeder just knows. All just got to get open. Oliver Ekman-Larsson pulls it, pulls everyone with him. Tobias Reeder gets inside position on the two Colorado defensemen. That is poorly played hockey by Colorado to allow this at this stage of the game. That's a nothing play. And Tobias Reeder puts it home.
It's Ivan Provorov. He has a tough time with it. Hurried by Stahlberg. Here he comes. Victor Stahlberg scores! He goes 5-hole on Michael Neuberg. And for the first time tonight, the Hurricanes have the lead.
You have to go back to Stahlberg creating a breakaway, drawing a penalty shorthanded with his explosive first few steps in the first period. His stick gets him going on the rookie Provorov, and then his acceleration has been on display in this game. Boy, did the Hurricanes add a player who can skate. And he's able to elude the stick to be able to get that puck through. Leave it's Mark Streit, just finds enough of the area between the legs to score.
And instead, Stahl is there. Banks it off the boards. Coburn holds it in again at the left point. Here's Johnson. And then Point has it swatted away. And now Rick Nash in on a breakaway. Here's Nash, shot, score! Turnover at the blue line becomes a breakaway, and Rick Nash converts. It's 1-0 Rangers.
I believe this was Nick Holden that made the defensive play. We'll get another look. Kept in. There's the reach there. Holden makes the defensive play, tips the puck out into the neutral zone, and Rick Nash, boy, what a quick release. Here he comes again. And that quick release, I think that's what Steve Valiquette was talking about. Anyway, he let it go quickly before Ben Bishop could get set. Over the left shoulder and the glove hand, and 1-0 Rangers.
We heard Derek Stepp gloved away by McDonough, and the Rangers look for a break. Here comes Grabner, down the middle. Grabner shot, score! Another breakaway leads to another goal. Michael Grabner's second of the night. It's 5-0 Rangers.
Yeah, we've talked about making the defensive plays all game, and the Rangers do it again. Kucherov will attempt a shot. JT Miller knocks it down, and very quickly, Grabner reacts. There's Grabner with the pressure. JT Miller ends up with the puck and just turns, spins, finds Grabner, and nobody's going to catch him. Grabner has had offensive chances in this game. That's at least his fifth shot on goal in this game. Quick wrist shot over the glove of Ben Bishop to make it 5-0.
And Vojtěch cranking one over the net. And it comes off the glass to center, picked up by Brown. Racing it on Halak. He shoots, he scores! A shorthanded goal to go with two power play goals. Tampa Bay's got a 5-0 lead.
Well, this is when you know your night is just not going your way. And a power play for the New York Islanders, and Johnny Vojtěch steps into the slapper with all his might. It misses the net, goes off the board, takes a tough carom off the glass, and sends JT Brown on the breakaway, and he makes a fantastic move. Just a bad bounce there for Calvin DeHaan. Good move here by JT Brown. Backhand, forehand, and gets it upstairs. But man, oh man, this has been a tough night for the New York Islanders. As we get a look at that goal again, when you elevate the puck, when you move it from side to side, you elevate.
And it's Gudas who winds up with the puck. Gudas springs Konechny. He's in on goal. Save, rebound. He scores. Konechny rams home his own rebound. And the Flyers take the 1-0 lead. Good defense leads to offense.
Yeah, and all that defense came from number three. Ratko Gudas did an outstanding job on a couple of one-on-ones with John Tavares. Normally the goal scorer goes by the bench first, but Gudas was so good on that play, he decided to beat Konechny, and he certainly beat Tavares. Outstanding job by Gudas, head up all the way, saucer pass, some air on it. Konechny follows his shot to the net. Outstanding read by Konechny, and then he just jams it home.
Yeah, what a great play, Joe, you said it by Gudas. I mean, he sets it up, he strikes a little fear into Tavares coming across the line. He peeled up, lost an edge, and then makes a great play up the middle. That's just great, great hockey all around.
One against Schwartz, lead pass. Jamie Benn's in behind. Benn to the forehand, and he's stoned by Allen. Sends it in front. Klingberg shuts goal! What an answer! His first of the season.
Well, there's a couple guys that combined in that goal that needed that to happen. Great outlet pass. Jamie Benn, he gets it poked off initially, but he stops on the puck. Stops, has his head up. John Klingberg continues to come off the ice. Good pass by Jamie Benn. Klingberg goes to the far side. Both of those guys really needed that. Hard-working shift by Jamie Benn. The key was, is he stops on the puck after he gets knocked off his stick.
So Paul Maurice has to juggle some lines to try to get some balance. Dustin Byfuglien, lead pass, in alone is Tanev, scores! Brandon Tanev! There's no doubt about this one. And with 1:16 to go, the Winnipeg Jets have a 4-3 lead.
Dustin Byfuglien just made up for that giveaway as he makes a great pass, but it starts in their own zone. Morrissey goes back, gets support from Dano. Dano's going to make a good play to the inside, and the speed, just talked about Tanev. He outraces Erickson, gets behind it, goes high glove. That's his spot. His second of the game, first career two-goal game. And a little bit of excitement as he jumps into the glass. 4-3 Winnipeg.
Well, he had to convince some people of the other one. He won't have to convince anybody of this one.
To help out. Backhand pass. Here's Smith. He's in behind everyone. Jamal Smith. Backhand scores! His first in the National Hockey League. A shorthanded goal. And a 2-0 lead.
And it is all about speed for Jamal Smith. We've been pulling for this kid since the first day of preseason. He works hard every time he's on the ice. He's been doing a lot of penalty killing. Him and McKenzie, a lot of extra time lately. Uses his speed, gets behind everybody, goes from that forehand to that backhand, gets it up over the top of the glove hand of Darling. Beautiful play by McKenzie. Great speed.
There was no catching him. He went to the backhand the other night, got messed up and hit a pipe.
Leaf now hit across the line. Off to Van Riemsdyk, tipped away by Couturier, racing forward to Simmons. Wayne Simmons has got it. In on goal! He scores! Short-handed goal for Simmons. He has a power play tally and now a shorty. And it's 3-2 Philadelphia.
It was a Couturier turnover that forced Mark Streit to take a tripping penalty on Zach Hyman. It's a forced turnover by Sean Couturier that sends Wayne Simmons off to the races on a breakaway. A nice job by Sean Couturier here at the blue line. He steals the puck, chips it up, and Wayne Simmons with that deceptively fast skating ability gets to the front of net and buries it.
Yeah, he was flying, Jonesy. Right past us. There's nobody coming close to him. He thought maybe Toronto might have a chance, but no way. Good play by Simmons. Perfect shot.
Pairing up as Voracek swoops in, feeds to Giroux. And that pass across, knocked down by Komarov. He's got a break. Leo Komarov scores! And Komarov's got his first of the year.
Turn on the light, Leo. 19 goals last year. His first this year. He takes a errant Claude Giroux pass, and he's off to the races. What impresses me here is he gets away from Shane Gostisbehere. Gostisbehere can't catch him. And then Komarov, the backhand. The Flyers still don't get a save as Mason gets beat through the five hole. But this is great news for the Leafs in this period. Hyman's first goal. Komarov's first goal, and the Leafs down 3-2, now lead 5-3.
Found a man open, Andokainer threw it up to the right side. Oh, a hard hit thrown by Hanley. He stepped up in a hurry and hit his man with his head down. Nearly a clear break by Byron. Scores! What a fast piece of work Byron is. Can he fly or what? Escape. Watch.
What a body check. I'm not sure if it was by accident they got on the same tracks or not, but that hit is what led to the turnover at the blue line. And then Byron, with a great stick check, is off to the races, and he is quick. You know, he's got that sleepy speed, and he goes backhand, forehand, and then gets it straight upstairs over the blocker of Howard, whose goals against average is 1.22, and that's already been blown up here. 8 minutes into this first period.
One, that stopped. Nugent Hopkins. His pass intercepted, and now here comes Grabner on a breakaway. Michael Grabner waits, shoots, and scores! Nope, wait. They wave it off. Maybe it didn't cross the goal line before the net came off.
I think
Grabner
it did.
Is celebrating.
Yeah, I think it went in. He stayed with it. I think he got it a second time before the net came off. What a play he made in his own zone to anticipate where the pass was going and just reach out with the stick. Those are the Oiler coaches on the bench looking at the replay. And here's the anticipation right there with the stick. And I think he'll make about three moves and then he'll stay with it instead of skating away. One, and then there's the other one. And I think that was over, even though Cam Talbot made just a great effort to keep it out. But I think it goes all the way over. I think this is going to count. This will even be a better look. I think it just, now we can't see it there because of the camera angle, but this one, let's see here. Where is it? Oh, no question. That will count, and for Michael Grabner, goal number two on the night.
Back around to Coburn. Made sure he was able to get a good one in that backhand clear. Here comes Brown, streaking, and he scores! J.T. Brown! Right down the middle, and Paquette found him with a brilliant pass. The Lightning open the scoring with 1:02 to go in the period.
Really good execution here. Relieving the pressure and lobbing the puck out of the zone was Coburn, and then Paquette tracking it down, and then Brown coming in layers. See, Brown just gets on his horse. He just blows by a couple of different Islanders, some of them not even trying to really get back into the picture there. That's terrific stuff there from JT Brown, but Paquette made a great play there. Paquette controls the puck, turns around, waits a little bit. Finally, Bailey was trying to catch up from Brown, but you're not going to catch JT Brown from that far behind.
Knocked down from behind was connecting. The puck did not get out of the zone, but Brassard turns it over. Here's Cousins again. Cousins cutting it on goal. Second of the year for Cousins. Had a chance earlier. Anderson won, but this time he buried it.
He went to the same side on Anderson this time, but he disguised the shot. And a great job by Brandon Manning, number 23, of getting in front of Brassard so he couldn't catch Cousins.
Just a terrible turnover there by Ottawa, though. Cousins is pouncing on this. It looked like Brassard was trying to get into a foot race. It just never really materializes. Chris Neal coming behind. Great goal. Good job by Cousins. Second chance opportunity. Makes it count.
A lot. Wilson up the middle, finds his man. Here's Arvidsson again. He scores! Victor Arvidsson again sneaking past the defense. And he got a perfect pass from Colin Wilson to make it 3-2.
Preds draw to within one. Victor Arvidsson, we've been talking plenty about him. Colin Wilson makes a terrific play right here. He'll get his stick in the lane right there. Disrupts that pass. Stop it, guys. You can see him. He's looking long for Victor Arvidsson. Recognizes that Arvidsson is in a great spot. Just him and Anderson if I get it there. And what a terrific finish by Victor Arvidsson. More like all Swedish.
Kevin Hayes is back. So all the guys who blocked shots and got off limping. Here's a break. Kevin Hayes breaks to the net. And he scores! A delayed penalty was being called. Kevin Hayes, led by Jesper Foss, passed. His second goal of the game makes it 4-1.
Sam, that would have been a penalty against Vancouver on Foss. Watch Foss 19 make the play. Right there, makes the play, and then he gets hooked on the play. But Hayes takes a rest, couple of moves. Gets the goaltender to move one way. Here it is again. What a defensive play by Foss. Gets hooked down, but still throws the puck in front of him to allow Kevin Hayes to go down the ice. And he gets Markstrom to go one way and go down. He puts it in the short side. What a huge goal for the Rangers.
And it is taken to the outside now and fled across. Can be bounced around for Malkin. Tried to feather it too. Nicely knifed away. Here is Beagle coming in on a shorthanded breakaway. Save me. Rebound. Score! It's Oshie. It's 1-0.
Well, the quick stick of TJ Oshie. Right there, causes the puck to fumble. There goes Jay Beagle. TJ Oshie follows up. What a save by Matt Murray initially. The second chance goes in shorthanded.
Evgeny Malkin put Christopher Letang in an almost impossible situation. Well played by Beagle and Oshie, but you have to wonder what Malkin was doing. He hung Letang out to dry.
From Bonino. Bonino tried to defend on Burakovsky, could not. It is Ovechkin moving in. He scores!
Well, Brian Dumoulin lost an edge right in front of the Capitol bench, and next thing you know, here comes Alexander Ovechkin. Looks like he's going to go back to the backhand, and he comes back to the forehand. Watch the move right here. Cuts back. Fleury going for the poke check. Wide open net.
He's been a presence all night long for the Washington Capitals. Size, strength, speed, finish.
Middle now. Nolan goes out for interference. Oilers want to take a one-goal lead here.
But the Kings get the loose puck. Here is Toffoli moving ahead to Carter. He's all alone. He shoots. He scores! Short-handed goal for Jeff Carter.
and the Kings lead 3-2.
Well, it starts, of course, in a faceoff. Now, what happens here with the Oilers? They have 4 men up. That's unusual. Look at Toffoli. He springs free. Another stop here, guys. From this point, Carter is gone. I mean, the Oilers don't spot him. And when you don't spot the speed of Jeff Carter, it's too late. Toffoli knows that. He's played with him so many times before. And Jeff's able. Now, the goaltender here, Gustafson, gets a chance. Watch how aggressive the goaltender is. He's going to be way at the top of the blue paint. But it's a perfect shot. Over the pad, under the glove. I mentioned the Oilers looking for one goal lead. Shorthanded, Kings lead it 3-2.
Tried to float it by in a great defensive play on a hustle back. And now Beauvillier is in alone. Score! Two goals in 43 seconds, and the Islanders lead Pittsburgh.
Good hustle by the Islanders. You mentioned it. Great back-checking by Travis Hamonic. He was trailing on the play, but he got his stick in the way, knocked it into the neutral zone, and then the Islanders used their speeds from transition. Watch this. Travis Hamonic just chips it back in the middle of the ice. Little turnover there by Letang, and Beauvillier's in perfect position. Look at the moves there. A little ha-ha, left-right, and then on the backhand, up high in the toy department on the goaltender Murray, and the Islanders have a 2-1 lead. How good does Beauvillier feel now in that play?
Tyler Bozak through the middle of the ice to the outside. Great read by Lindholm. Now Stahlberg with a shorthanded breakaway. Walks in and scores! Victor Stahlberg with Carolina's second shorty of the season. And the Hurricanes have a 2-1 lead.
Boy, is Lindholm ever shining shorthanded right now, creating all sorts of things with what he's doing shorthanded. And your eventual goal scorer after Lindholm denies the entry with a great stick. Bats this thing out of midair right onto his tape. It was on edge, so he had to get that puck flat. And then nobody's going to catch Victor Stahlberg. Not with his power in his first couple of steps. And he looks up, sees the room on the blocker's side.
Away by Brody, who reached around and batted the puck free. Flames get it back, and away they go. Stage into center. Here's Bennett with a bit of room. Sam Bennett shoots, scores! What a goal for Sam Bennett. Partial breakaway beats it open. It's 1-0 Calgary.
And the Bruins are talking about puck management. Well, turn of events here. David Krejci with a nice play to back as he has a full head of steam right here. But incredible play by TJ Brody right there to knock the puck off the stick of Backes. Away they go the other way. Staging perfectly placed pass and an even better shot by Sam Bennett. High short side. And that's what the youngster needed for sure, Bennett. He has really been pressing, playing awfully hard, but points and goals have not been coming lately.
Stop by Cam Talbot. Now the puck will be moved out, and here's Connor McDavid. Gets it in over the line, and he's in, and he scores! Connor McDavid early. And the Oilers have taken a 1-0 lead.
Well, we talked about Connor McDavid at the start of the show. For this reason alone, you can't give him room. You have to know who you're on the ice against. You have to back off if he's on the ice. Beautiful feed.
He and Burakovsky come on together here. As the puck comes out through center, what a great pass. In comes Martin, he shoots, he scores! Matt Martin opens the scoring, and Toronto has a 1-0 lead. Beauty of a goal.
Well, the play was made along the wall here as Marner at the end of the shift just looked up and saw him. You see the reaction there of Carlson. You always have a sense of where the dangerous guys are on the ice. Martin, not known as a scorer, got his first goal in 20 on Wednesday night, and he follows it up with just a beauty made by the pass of the youngster Marner. He just taped to tape it, a long one. Stay on the ice and get the plus there as Marner celebrates as good as anyone.
Rebound. Victor Rask has control. Skinner all alone. Jeff Skinner walks in and scores! Jeff Skinner has tied it.
Well, we said back in the first period that Jeff Skinner, even when Carolina got down a couple of goals, he had a lot of jump, and you'd hear from him before the day was done. That's now turned into night. Rask leads him with a pass. Ekblad and Skinner, oh, a couple of minutes ago, two former rookies of the year, and had a battle that Ekblad won, not this one. The strength of Skinner. Leg spread, the edge work, warding off of Ekblad, and then on the backhand, being able to elevate that puck, hands up to the crossbar.
Point here, Kulak, a shot, blocked off, and the Flyers bust out with a puck. Lee pass Simmons, he's in on goal! Score! Number 11 for Simmons, the Flyers with a couple of goals, separated by just 24 seconds.
What a play by Wayne Simmons. What a move, the block shot in front here. The quick outlet pass by Cousins. It's on the tape, and then Simmons just walks Johnson to the backhand. What a play, though, by Cousins at the other end, just making it. And Simmons is going to win a foot race against anybody. We've seen that the last couple of weeks, guys, as he's had breakaways. But the beautiful little floater by Cousins up the middle, Simmons with a terrific finish.
Back out to the point, Goodbranson. His shot blocked. Here comes Zucker for Minnesota. Zucker in alone for the Wild. He scores! And there's the answer for Minnesota.
The Wild are going to need a couple of inspired efforts such as that. Zucker just blocks a shot. That's where the speed will pay off for him. You know that he was going to outleg that defender. And gets down, makes this move, and goes very quick to the backhand. That's the secret of the move for him. He made it happen very quickly. Tough for the goaltender to adjust the depth. And the glove on that one. So Zucker gets the Wild within one.
A human chia pet now, partner, up here.
Here's a chance for Panic. He's going to get right into the back. And he's gone! Richard Panic snaps a long drought and puts the Hawks in front.
Well, a bouncing puck. And Richard Panic. Hadn't scored a goal since October 22nd. A beautiful move, forehand, backhand, and the reaction.
Sanin fumbled, and Cizik is forced it on for Shane Prince. He scores! The momentum belonged to the Capitals, but the lead is the Islanders. It's Prince, and it's 1-0 New York.
Well, it all starts really with the great penalty kill. Lubetskin had several opportunities. One, he's going to end up dinging off the post as we watch Holtby saying, how did that one get by me? But watch Halak really as OV snaps that first one. That's off the post. Halak is just trying to find his way. Look at the aggressive Halak. I mean, he knows he's going to wire it. He's way out. He's going to use his defenseman to help him out with the rebound scenarios. He's focusing in on the number one opportunity. And then the turnover, Cizikas forced it on Orlov, up over the glove. Favorite spot for lefties to go on lefties is up over the glove.
And Sproul couldn't handle the pass, and he gives it away to Marchessault. And Barkov ahead of the field, breakaway in overtime. Alexander Barkov, let's go home, baby! Game winner for Barkov at the Joe! And the Panthers pull it out, 2-1. Unreal.
Unreal Barkov night. Incredible how hard he worked, how much time he put into this. And you got to remember, it's 22 games since he last scored a goal during the play. This is an OT game winner. Incredible. How does he have the steam? Line mates have already got off. Look at the cool slide between the legs. You got to be happy for Barkov. Nobody's happier than Coach Tom Rowe, who earlier today said he's going to come out of this and he's going to score plenty for us. How about scoring the game winner tonight? Great game. Great game by Young.
He puts it right back to Nolan.
There's a chance back and over the line. Reeder, he ends apart, and the Coyotes get it right back. Oh, what a strange game it's been.
And the roof is ready to pop off here at Gila River. What a play up the ice. We've seen this already this game. Tobias Reeder gets a step on Drew Doughty. See you later. Walks right around him. This year, Chaz Roberts, school player of the game, and he finds the top of the net, and I mean the top.
Period. Harry Price and goal, pass right side. Here's Lewis cutting in. Lewis in front, he shoots, he scores!
Great play by Lewis. Cut in front of the net and put the backhander in. And the Kings regain the lead at 4-3.
Sometimes you have vision as the passer. Bob, I could hear Trevor Lewis tap his stick from up here. He's going to be on the far side, right side. You hear that? He tapped his stick, and that caught the attention of Andre Kopitar. Then, look at this. Patience, patience, hold on. Man, the balance scoring the Kings are getting of late. They've got to pick up wins. This is four goals now against Carey Price.
For Ottawa so far, and hasn't played the next game yet.
It happens.
Now a centering pass, Turris, and alone scores! Kyle Turris set in, and the breakaway goal ties this game at one.
Terrific execution. This all starts in the defensive zone. Mike Sullivan's taking a peek to see what happened. Kyle Turris is gonna get a great pass, but Dion Phaneuf, little D-to-D play. Weidman's gonna pop it right through the middle. Dzingel speed, and then a little saucer play. Threads the needle. Turris actually shows high glove and then rolls his wrist at the last second. That creates some deception on Marc-Andre Fleury, who freezes him and slides it 5-hole with a terrific play. And the Ottawa Senators are at 1-1 with 11:42 left in this first period.
Yep. Look at that. A steal for Cullen. Phaneuf's going to try to get back. Carlson trying to catch Cullen to the goal. Score! Beautiful goal by Cullen, shorthanded.
Well, you'd like to say it was a goaltending change, but I don't think that's what it was. It was pressure by the Penguins. Take a look. Phaneuf flat-footed. The puck comes right up the middle of the ice. Carlson's way over to the right. Phaneuf's over by the bench. So you got two defensemen on the ice, but they're miles apart. And Cullen goes to the backhand, elevates off the goalpost over that glove. Carlson just could not get back and lift the stick of Cullen. Cullen veers to his right.
That time kicked at the puck, sent it into the corner. Rantanen retrieves, send it out high. Clean block. Here's Robertson. Robertson on the breakaway. He scores! Robertson blocked it, collected it, and then buries it.
Inside of the dot, watch Victor Arvidsson. It's all Victor Arvidsson.
Puck cycles out high, back to the point, does a great job, plugs the lane, blocks the shot, presence of mind, this is mine, locates it, gathers up, and then he is off to the races, quick little snapper, Victor Arvidsson, eighth of the year, and know this, last 2 years, 8 goals per year in each of those 2 years, already matched a season high from last year.
6 minutes of the game were the best sequence for the Coyotes. Here's Hossa with a chance. He drives and shoots. He scores! Marian Hossa able to fend off the check of Chychrun and fire a slap shot home. It's 4-0.
What a great pass by Nicholas Jalmerson, our Xfinity telestrator. Marian Hossa, he's offside right now, but he has to get to this side of the blue line first and make sure that puck beats him into the zone. That's what he does. He gets a step on Chychrun.
And maybe Mike Smith was a little surprised, Pat. Maybe it wasn't as hard as a shot that it came because of the pressure from the defenseman from the Coyotes.
Chara, also the goaltender Rask. Lots of confusion. Pastrnak scores!
We talked about the physical development of David Pastrnak. Here's Exhibit A of what we're talking about. He wins a race, and watch how strong he is at the point of attack. Quickness and pace against Kuznetsov. He just out-muscles Kuznetsov at the point of attack. Comes in on Holtby, puts it through the wickets. We have a one-goal spread. What a dominating type of play by Pastrnak.
And especially with a rolling puck. More times than not, the player's gonna cut back and go the other way, but Pastrnak goes to the backhand, and I think surprises Braden Holtby.
Moves in for a shot, rejected by Ward, scissoring out that pad. A stretch pass, here comes Aho, all alone, and he scores! That's hockey, baby! Sebastian Aho with a great finish, and Carolina has a two-goal lead.
Boy, again, using so much of east-west. Randy Carlisle's looking to see if he's going to challenge on offsides. Maybe we'll watch the entry clearly. What a pass here from Stepniak. He's had a great period. Lindholm falls. Hampus Lindholm, that is. And much similar that McClement did. Starting it on the backhand, and then with that long stick that Aho uses with great balance, he creates.
Throws it across into the far faceoff circle for Tracy. Down low, pass in front, blocked, scrambled for the puck, still loose. And the Bruins are on the power play. Rugo can't hold on the puck, it's a breakaway chance. Here comes McKinney, shoots and he scores! His second short-handed goal of the season, Nathan McKinnon. And it's 2-0 for the Avalanche.
All you can say is wow. What a shot. It looked like he was getting caught a little bit. There's a big scramble. This is the second time that Pickard has made and been involved maybe in a save or a scramble down low, that and all of a sudden the Avs are going the other way. And here comes McKinnon. It looks like he's getting caught. Like, I thought he might have shot that from a little far out, but I was dead wrong. Just a rocket over the shoulder.
Burrows gets it out. Chasing after the puck is Bo Horvat. Turning on the Jets. Horvat in on goal. Deeks scores! Bo Horvat makes it 3-0 with his 12th of the year. And the young man in the corner with the blue sign is getting a wiener dog.
And they're going to name him Horvat.
Bo
Horvat. Every dog's named Bo. And here's Bo. Look at the speed. He just pulls away from Connor Murphy and then Mike Smith. Wow. Horvat fakes like he's going to go forehand. And look at Mike Smith. His right leg ends up all the way around the post. And Bo Horvat goes to the backhand.
Soderberg flipping the forehand around. Pastrnak's out of the box. Schaller goes indirect. Pastrnak onto it. Rebound scores. David Pastrnak cashes in right out of the penalty bench.
This is what you hope turns the game for the Bruins. And as this play is coming through the neutral zone, your total focus is he going to be onside? The pass from Schaller deep in the Bruins zone or between the tops of the circles and the blue line is going to be indirect off the wall in behind Pastrnak. And does he move laterally enough to stay onside? It sure looks like it. And then the stick-to-itiveness, the initial move didn't work. It worked enough to get Pickard to slide from left to right. But he makes the stop, and then Pastrnak doesn't do the flyby. He's going to hang around.
Great point of this opening period, and Montreal with a 4-0 lead. Will this be 5? Yes, sir! Colorado being cut to ribbons by the Montreal Canadiens in this first period.
Well, the other night, the Avalanche got a lucky break when Torrey Krug lost his footing, and it was off to the races for MacKinnon. And right here, it's just a play that comes out of the neutral zone. Zadorov tries to glove the puck. He loses his balance, and it's Paul Byron who's just all over it. Johnny on the spot. He's so quick, and when he smells a loose puck like that, good luck. He is gone, and the Canadians are just finishing everything. And Varlamov, who came out of the gate cold, is just, he's not even moving. I mean, this thing beat him before he even got his glove off his pad. And
I think that's the first time in three games that a Slavin clear has not cleared. Pavelski kept it in, but then he followed up, did Slavin to get it to Stahlberg to get the clear.
Logan Couture pops it out. Victor Rask, a foot race. Joakim Nordstrom, he'll get in shorthanded. He scores! He fought off Brent Burns, and Joakim Nordstrom has his second goal this season against Arendelle and the Sharks. This one shorthanded. Carolina has tied it.
What a goal. I just said that with the second period Ryan goal the other night. Let's watch this action. It doesn't get much better than this. Here's Nordstrom. Pesci, great job. He's had a heck of a stick in this period with the support of Victor Rask. And then this is where it becomes special. I mean, the strength of that swiping stick from Burns where there's contact with the legs and he stays on his feet.
Deflected, did not end up on net and cleared out of the zone. Back to get it, and a breaking shot, score! Jeff Carter, the puck just came to him right on the stick, nobody on him, and the Kings have a 2-0 lead.
I mentioned team defense a shift ago, and it was the same thing here, where four guys at 4-on-4. It becomes more of a man-on-man. Now, Tyler Toffoli will end up getting Carter the puck. Watch Toffoli backing off right there. He just, it's a perfect pass to a player he's played basically his entire career with. He knows with Jeff Carter, he does not want to risk the stick-on-stick pass. He just wants to get it to open ice. Then watch it with Carter. No deception. No deception whatsoever. It's all quick wrists. Get it off the stick as quick as possible.
Parisi back in the Minnesota zone. Gives to Spurgeon and ahead to Pominville. Long pass and Stahl in. Stahl alone. Save, rebound, he scores! Another breakaway for Erik Staal. This time he finishes on the rebound, and it's 3-0 Minnesota.
It's not an accident that Staal gets breakaways. He reads the play so very well. In this, he gets a little bit of a step on the defender for Florida, and this time he finishes it off because he follows up his rebound. He's being checked and poked on the play. Good blocker save, bats it out of the air and gets the Wild up 3-0. Staal.
Pass across, deflected, as Botnin got a stick on it. Out of the box, Bieksa takes the long lead pass. He's in on a breakaway. Score! Kevin Bieksa, just like they drew it up.
That looked easy for Bieksa. Boy, oh boy, he just snapped that five hole. A good alert heads up play by Getzlaf. This puck, Getzlaf lifts a stick, gets to the bounce, delivers a strike, and in goes Kevin Bieksa. And boy, he made his mind up to go five hole from the moment he got that puck on his stick. That was close to being offside too. I mean, he had to gain control of it because he was going backwards over the line.
The Bruins are taking a look.
Well, they might protest this and ask to make sure that that was onside.
Away by Zajac, shorthanded, able to feed Adam Henrique. Here's Henrique shorthanded, he scores! A shorthanded goal by Adam Henrique, and the Devils take the lead in St. Louis.
Well, what a start for the Devils here. And Adam Henrique, we've seen that in the past so often, and that's something that could really spark him. What a beautiful play by Zajac. And Ben Lovejoy, watch his pass. Adam Henrique knocks it out of midair, hunts on the back of him, but he's able to go to the backhand and go upstairs. Jake Allen gets a little piece of it, but Adam Henrique shorthanded gets the Devils a 1-0 lead.
Up it in the middle, shot that deflected off a group. Shan was there, turned to center. Here comes Toffoli. Toffoli a step. Toffoli in. And he scores! Great goal as they got that one up ice in a hurry and a big 3-1 lead.
There's always been this discussion about Tyler Toffoli not being a great skater. He's at his fastest, like many, when he's being chased. And when he's being chased, that's when he turns it on. But watch the puck protection he's able to do, all at top speed. So he gets the loose puck. There was all kinds of pressure by the Red Wings, the best pressure they had all night. Lean, look at the defenseman's stick. He wants to get to the puck. That's Cronwall, but excuse me, the Kaiser. He can't. And then just not enough room for the goaltender to kind of, he's backing off on the play like he has to do.
So Toffoli's got a goal and an assist tonight and gives the Kings a 3-1 lead.
Jamie Benn, take it away. Here comes Rick Dash. That's it all alone on Niemi. He scores! Short-handed goal by Rick Nash gives the Rangers a 1-0 lead.
What a read this was. Jamie Benn thought he was going to draw Rick Nash to him and throw it the other way. And Rick Nash right here, watch him anticipate that. Turns just as Jamie Benn turned to make the pass. How about the release? That shot was off the stick right here. Bang! In the net. Past Niemi before he can react. And Rick Nash back in the lineup. Does that shorthanded. Number 5 on the season for the Rangers in that department. And they lead it.
Only Calgary has more with 6.
Monahan on the power play, goal on the 5-on-3, and it's broken up by Calvert. Calvert now scoots into the zone, he's got a breakaway. Walks in, shorthanded, scores! His second shorthanded goal of the season. The Jackets 4th, and they lead 4-1.
Well, Johnny Goodrow's got all the skill in the world, but in this play, he gets a little too fancy right at the blue line as the power play for the Calgary Flames is trying to get set. Goodrow tries to feather a pass across, and Matty Calvert is coming in the middle of your screen, knocks it off, then he's off to the races. You can see Calvert and Carlson, who outraces the defender for the Flames. If there was any kind of rebound, here's a great look at it. Matty Calvert anticipating that pass, breaks it up, and makes no mistake.
Matt Calvert now, 4 goals on the year, half of them are on the shorthanded variety.
Left it in the corner for McKenzie, turns and clears, and Riley Smith after a loose puck shorthanded. Smith is in, Smith to the backhand, score! It's the life of Riley! Shorthanded goal for the lead in the third period.
Oh, you gotta love that sense of confidence. He read the play beautifully. And then the way he puts that puck behind the goaltender just amazes me. I mean, he has got to find a 5-hole. There's not a lot there. Watch how this happens on the backhand. There's not a lot there. Picker didn't have those legs wide open for very long, but it was the anticipation, picking up the puck off the board, and a shorthanded goal. What a goal for Riley Smith. And the Avalanche finally paying the price for allowing breakaways.
Perron trying to shield on Van Riemsdyk, who recovered beautifully, but now here's Berglund. A wrist shot. Boy, Berglund with a mishandle cost himself what could have been a good look. Kane's going to get a look. Right to the goal. Kane, he scores! Patrick Kane sprung on a breakaway from center ice in, and Kane has got the tying goal.
What a pass from Trevor Van Riemsdyk. The Blues went for a change, Pat. And when that happened, Patrick Kane took off. Stop it right here. Look at this area. The Blues are here. Kane is here. And he's off to the races. And he beats Jake Allen. Just barely. With the instincts and the recognition, Pat, that there was open ice, and I'm gonna take that ice.
Never got through. Hammond for Beauvillier on a breakaway. Score! A save on one end, a goal on the other, and the Islanders down 2 have tied it.
Couple of game-saving saves by Berube. Boy, close, in close. And then the quick pass from Hamonic to Anthony Beauvillier, who was just coming off the bench. He saw the opportunity, broke into the opening, and he made absolutely no mistake. He wondered if he was going to maybe try for the deep. There's the shot. quick one by Hamannik. Gets his feet moving, and there's Beauvillier in behind the defense, and then the quick wrist shot. He makes absolutely no mistake about that. But that play starts with a great save, and then Travis Hamannik, two or three real quick steps, clears himself, and then a beautiful pass to Anthony Beauvillier.
Tried to get to the inside, and Orlov said, no, you don't. A lead for Ovechkin behind the D. Ovechkin deeks. He scores! Alex Ovechkin, free and clear.
And that is exactly what happens when the Caps get a break. Ovechkin in alone, and then you have a bad read by a 22-year-old goalie. When a poke check doesn't work, you're in deep trouble. The alley-oop to Ovi, and there's the poke check attempt by Vasilevskiy, and it's an easy layup for Alex Ovechkin. Orlov, the alley-oop, and here comes the grade 8 into your living room. Nice shot over the right pad. Calms the puck down. That is a goal scorer's goal. Orlov, the perfect alley-oop. The Capitals D have been involved heavily here tonight.
The NHL career point counter for Alex Ovechkin, 10 away from 1,000.
Austin Czarnik fending on a pass. Broken up, breakaway, shorthanded. Jordan Staal, all alone, he scores! In need of some energy, Jordan Staal with Carolina's fifth shorthanded goal of the season. They cut the lead in half.
Well, he's wearing a letter for a reason. Had his best game coming back from a concussion last night in Buffalo. Austin Czarnik, a forward playing the point on the Boston power play. And Jordan Staal comes in with a ton of speed, which you see how effective that is in shootouts. Takes a look, sees that Hudobin is actually pretty deep. Pretty deep, drifting backwards. And that's always been an effective spot to shoot halfway up on the blocker side on breakaways, and was that ever.
Gets it down along the boards, back to the blue line. Hopped by Stone, racing up after it. Komarov in there, he scores! Leo Komarov with his second of the night. And the Leafs take a 3-1 lead.
Stone gets just comes off the bench, comes back to the point. A rolling puck just goes over his stick, and Komarov was already off to the races. And what I love about this goal is Komarov's last move. I mean, he has his head up, and it's a difficult play for a goalie when the player comes across and tucks it back 5-0. And he just takes off. He saw some light, beat Stone, and then beat Smith right in the 5-0. A beautiful goal. And for me, watching him conduct himself as a professional.
Pass up ahead, in comes Nylander. Oh, beautiful! Bullseye! And William Nylander ends a 13-game goalless streak in very pretty fashion.
Great play off the draw by Gauthier, and then he just takes off. We've seen this speed from the Maple Leafs all game long. Smith overcommits. Nylander with that speed. Oh, what a play. He just chips it up over top of the goaltender when Smith goes down far too early on this play and gives away the top half of the net, and Nylander with a beautiful goal to finish it off.
Long stretch pass is a beauty from Zetterberg. Tatar scores! Tomas Tatar on a great feed from the captain, and it's a 2-2 tie.
Well, once again, as it has been like all season, Henrik Zetter brings this team back and ties this game with just an unbelievable stretch pass here. This is just tape to tape from the veteran to Tatar, who's getting hot now at this point in the season. He has a great finish to the stick side of Condon, but heads up by Zetterberg, splits the deep. Tatar, no doubt, goes in, knows we're gonna shoot, head is up. That looks like a confident Tatar. That's who we saw last year when he was scoring in bunches and playing a solid brand of hockey. And that's the Tatar the Red Wings need to continue to score if they want to climb up the standings. Big goal for the Wings.
Coach for Devan Dubnyk, so very familiar with him. Said his work ethic
is almost as good as Bobrovsky.
Breakaway. Atkinson shoots and scores! The Blue Jackets spring Atkinson free. And forget about the goose egg now. After two games without a point, Cam Atkinson comes up with a go-ahead goal. And the Blue Jackets, for the 24th time in 35 games this season, are first on the scoreboard.
Well, the Blue Jackets lost the faceoff in the offensive zone. And here come the Wild with just a flip play through the zone in the neutral zone. It's a turnover. Brandon Dubinsky. And off goes Cam Atkinson. Nice little shot past Devin Dubnyk. You're right, Cam was getting a little frustrated last game. He's getting these opportunities. But excellent job by the Columbus Blue Jackets. There's that speed game from Cam Atkinson.
16th goal of the year for Atkinson.
Perry came to the net. He's stripped of the puck as he was getting ready to shoot it. And now a right wing pass for Kessel against Johnston. Powers his way to the goal. Scores!
Don't forget about me. Number three in All-Star voting. Phil Kessel, all the damage he's done against Carey Price. A pass behind his back. Johnson tries to grab the jersey and the pants of Kessel. And Kessel goes to the backhand, takes it wide on Carey Price. Look at how he protects the puck, gets the elevation over the pad. Phil Kessel, that's brilliance right there. The ex-Leaf.
And it scores free, loose for a moment, but Tkachuk gets it away, and here comes Foley. Michael Foley scores!
Wow.
Two goals last night, and maybe the dagger tonight.
And a nine-game point streak for Matthew Tkachuk. He extends it to nine games. He's the one with the outlet pass stretch to Frolik. Just a heads-up play by the youngster. Good defensive zone structure. Pounce on the loose puck. Get it up and bang. Right on the tape for Leek goes in alone. And he just beats Marstrom to the blocker's side. You see Marstrom afterwards not happy with himself. He felt he saw that puck coming. But just a good, quick release. A little bit further out from Frolik. The celebration afterwards. That shows you how big that goal was for the Flames as the Canucks have been pushing in this third period.
Frolik with his 10th of the season at the 18-10 mark of the third.
Trocheck tries to get a wrap around all the way back to Marchessault. Here's Brad Marchand on a shorthanded breakaway. He deeks. He scores! Marchand with a shorty, the third for the Bruins this season. And Boston has drawn first blood.
Well, at first you get a little nervous because Char's on his backhand and he's going for the high lob to get it out of the defensive zone. Doesn't get enough on it, but it caused some problems. And again, the high risk that Keith Yandel is, because he's an offensive-minded defenseman. He's standing at that left point. He tries to one-time that backhand clearing attempt. And Marchand gets right in the shooting lane, makes the steal. He's able to contain the puck and just get some separation from Yandel and attack the net with speed. A little pump fake with a forehand. Love when guys have breakaways and they know there's pressure on the backside, so you keep your speed up and it almost just takes over as far as your instincts, Jack, and you make a move to the back.
Now he sends it up to center. It skips off Logan Couture's stick. Now Logan gets it back. In alone. He scores! Logan Couture! And the Sharks get one back. It's 5-3.
Well, what an individual effort by the all-around greatness of Logan Couture. And he steals the puck at the blue line right there. And then comes in, the puck is rolling, fights off a check, he gets tripped. And somehow that thing squeaks past Cam Talbot. And you could see Andre Sekera diving, landed up losing his stick. And what a job by Logan Couture.
Ryan Kessler couldn't get to the puck, the Avalanche. Maneuver out to center ice, poked ahead, picked up, there's a breakaway chance, McKinnon, yeah! What a goal! What a poke check, and then the speed separated him from the Ducks, and a beautiful backhander has tied the game at one. Well, he scored the last goal before the All-Star, or this five-day layoff, Mike. And it was in overtime, a nice little deflection in front of the power play. But this, like, watch him separate himself from the Anaheim players. He just, they're looking at him disappear. That's about all they were doing right there. What a move to the back end. Like, have you seen that move before?
I've seen him do it on shootouts.
Okay, but I'm just,
but that's not necessarily his move
on breakaways, is it?
That was, I mean, he made that look so smooth.
Konechny gets underneath Chara and gets underneath his skin, and Chara gives him a little what for. Dale Weiss back to Sean Couturier. Marchand with the deflection. He's got a partial break, shorthanded. He scores! Brad Marchand! It's his second shorthanded goal of the season, the fourth for the Bruins. Philadelphia allows its eighth shorty, the worst in the league, and it's all tied.
Well, the possibilities were there for some kind of penalty call or penalty shot possibility after the steal. Again, it's great work along the boards. The Bruins penalty killers committed in those battles on the right side of the puck. We saw it earlier on the Nash chance, and now you've seen it on the breakaway by Marchand. Marchand with a steal. He's in alone. He's got separation. It's just he and Neubert, and then the stick work on the back check. But that puck just kept rolling. Had enough on it to get under the stick of Neubert, through his legs.
That is not why he's playing with the Canadiens.
This was a missed pass from the Canadian end. The pass was meant for Galchenyuk in the middle of the ice, and he missed it. And everyone missed it, and the speed of Pacioretty blows by McDonough, and he beats Henrik on the five hole. And you know what? You got to have a save here. You're Henrik Lundqvist, you're on the road, you lost last night, your team's leading. Two goals like that happen, and you got to have a save for the Rangers.
The shot from Postman comes in wide, and a big hit by Mark Stewart on the far side, right in front of the bench. The Sharks score, going back the other way.
It was almost like Winnipeg was watching what was going on, and Timo Meier comes in. Little howdy do, goes to his forehand, puts it top corner.
Gets the puck to Trocheck. Trocheck, centering pass, picked off by Draisaitl. Draisaitl getting it to McDavid. Connor McDavid, the game on his stick. McDavid scores! Connor McDavid.
Wait a
thinks
second.
He has a goal. James Reimer thinks he has the puck.
James Reimer has it in his glove, and the glove is past the goalpost. This is a very, very tough call. There's the glove. The puck is in the glove. You can see the puck in the glove through the webbing. That's a goal.
After a video review, the call on the ice is confirmed. We have a good goal.
McDavid's second time. He scored in overtime, and the Oilers defeat the Panthers by the score of 4-3.
By Zaitsev, this is Bozak in front, Holden cleared it aside. Hayes gets to it. Nice pass to Miller. He breaks into Grabner. Grabner scores! A shorthanded goal for Michael Grabner.
What a pass from Kevin Hayes. He had to thread this pass between two Leafs players, and Grabner, what a game he's played. Coming back to Toronto after being here last season, and here's the pass. Beautiful pass right onto the tape, and then there's a shot. He snapped that one. And Anderson, who's made so many big saves throughout. So the Rangers make a good defensive play, and then Hayes with that pass right onto the tape of Grabner. Huge goal for the Rangers, shorthanded.
The Rangers' seventh shorthanded goal of the season.
He got it through. It trickled on Grice, who makes the save. And now Tavares is up for a breakaway. He's got the only goal in the game so far. Make it two! A shorthanded goal for John Tavares, and the New York Islanders have a lead here in the third period with 3:06 to go.
They absolutely need
breakaway was Lettinen who made the save. John went up higher. This time he went a little bit lower. And you can see he's completely out of breath. Up and down, up and down. Kuhlman should have shot the puck earlier on as Tavares gave him the opportunity. Especially when you're killing a penalty. You take a look at Sagan, he just rifles that one and hits the post. Thomas Greiss is not sure where. You can see he's in the middle of that, can't get back in time. But he played his angle well enough that didn't get the opportunity. And John Tavares starts off. This is Kuhlman. This is a 3-on-1. Kuhlman has to shoot that one. 2-on-1 the other way. Sharp, good play by the defenseman Seidenberg. And then Tavares with another opportunity. Speed. Forehand, backhand, back to the forehand, and the Islanders have an all-important second goal.
Still has a period to go. The most they've scored since they had 7 in the season opener against Calgary. Here's Monahan. Monahan steps in, shoots, scores! And it's a 5-game goal streak for Sean Monahan.
Just a little pickoff here. Good job by Monahan to get his feet moving right away. As he gets this puck, and you know, this is the type of start you want to have. If you're the Flames, you're down, you got to try and make a period of it. And that's 5 games in a row, as you mentioned, Dave, for Monahan. Head up the whole way. He beats Maroon back and goes right up over top of the blocker side shelf. So a spark here early for the Flames.
And Kessler battling there for the puck. Poked ahead by Zucker. It's another odd man rush. Zucker with Granlund. Back to Zucker. Zucker scores!
Watch the pass Mikhail Granlund makes when he gets it from Zucker. He threads it between the feet of the defenseman, right back to Zucker. The passing plays that these two guys make are simply incredible. And Mikhail Granlund waits out the defender and he puts it through the wickets to Zucker, who then banks one off the pipe. Amazing.
Goal came in San Jose for Bufflin, back for Morrissey, and for Brian Little. Scores!
For Brian Little, and it's a great stretch pass up. This is what the Jets need to get some momentum back in this game. And it's a good breakout. Bufflin over to Morrissey. Morrissey, great little pass as Little gets inside position and he fights off. There was a penalty on the play as Joel Ward hooked a slash, and Little to the backhand puts it underneath the pads of Dell to tie the game at 1.
Now Ryan Reeves cuts to the net. He shoots and scores! Ryan Reeves has given the Blues a 2-0 lead here in Pittsburgh.
Well, Ryan Reeves, not the guy that you would expect to add to the scoring for the St. Louis Blues, but he does just that. And a job by the St. Louis Blues just to get this puck up the wall, a good bounce for them, and then the speed of Ryan Reeves as he turns on the Jets. He's able to take it from his backhand to his forehand. As you see, Schultz trying to find position to get in on him. He chose to go over him instead of staying inside of him. And at that point, Reeves is able to take it to his forehand and he puts it through Matt Murray. Good job by Ryan Reeves to get on his horse and get that goal.
No score, 5 shots for Toronto, 2 for the Flyers. We don't clear there, but now it's Konechny getting to it to Simmons. He's got the breakaway. In on goal! He scores! For Wayne Simmons, his 21st goal of the year, and it's 1-0 Philadelphia.
Scored in Brooklyn, scored in Manhattan. How about 3 consecutive, 1 at home? Great work by the Flyers, being patient, getting the puck out, making plays, took advantage of a miscue at the blue line, and then little Travis Konechny, perfect feed to Wayne Simmons, and he really delayed. It looked like he was going to deke to the backhand, not Not a deke, a shot.
Simmons has had a propensity to get streaky through his entire career, and it's clearly on it again, as you just mentioned. Three goals now in three games. Great move, totally faked out McElhaney. And that is a great goal by Simmons. Kind of shake the cobwebs off the Flyers in the early going to get them the lead.
Scandella has his shot blocked by Laterra. And now Tarasenko on a breakaway, moving it on Dubnyk. He scores!
Well, this is a huge goal for Vladimir Tarasenko. No goals in his last eight games. Was trying hard to get one in the Pittsburgh game. Wasn't able to get it. A good job here. A quick up. And Tarasenko in alone on a breakaway is able to sneak this one past Devan Dubnyk. But a good job by the Blues to quick up it. And you see he puts it five hole on Devan Dubnyk. You almost wonder if Dubnyk thought he was going to deke to his forehand. And right as he opened up, Tarasenko was able to snap that one quickly through Devan Dubnyk's five hole.
Tyler Seguin let that go. Meanwhile, this kicks across. And here comes Brent Burns on a breakaway. He
the aggressive and quick defense from the Pacific Division taking advantage of their opportunities. And Brent Burns probably going to win the Norris Trophy this year, showing a little bit of his offensive skill.
There is 340, but it is five, and a good stop by Martin Jones.
Patrick Laine has Nathan McKinnon. They've had three or four really good chances.
Here's Horvat. He scores!
Nifty hands, and he knows how to score, and there's an example of it. He is really an underappreciated young player in the game today.
Led back over, and here's Carlson. Erik Karlsson of the Ottawa Senators, taken away by Simmons. The ex-LA King drifting on in. He scores!
Well, Wayne Simmons shows his breakaway speed and then just chips this puck up and over the shoulder of Carey Price. Beautiful shot from the power forward of the Flyers.
Intended to fall. More changes at both benches. Taylor Hall is out there with Wayne Simmons. Simmons came up with two, and here is Seth Jones. He scores! Seth Jones has tied the game.
Hall's got a chance to move it right now, but he waits, and then he recognizes that Jones is all by himself.
Drops Jones, meant for Hall, off of him. Kessler looks ahead for McDavid and got it to him. In a load, lots of moves, and he scores!
But Connor McDavid gets a pass from Ryan Kessler. Forehand, backhand, and almost follow that puck right into the back of the net.
Fowler a shot, and it went wide off the glass and hopped on out, and Cam Atkinson with a lot of speed moving on in. Save made by Smith, rebound popped in off of him, and the game is tied.
Well, the two Boston College guys get into a drag race. Cam Atkinson, the puck's going to come high and hard off the stick of Cam Fowler off to the race. A little backspin. Goudreau hunting down on Atkinson. Can he catch him? 13 versus 13. And the white 13 gets it. Not the first time around, Eddie and Doc, but stay with it. Follow your shot to the net and put it to the upper part of the net.
Adam Henry, complete player. He's getting it done defensively tonight.
On the penalty kill, this is Henrique, shorthanded. Scores! Adam Henrique never got a true shot away, it seemed, but it trickled past Coro, and the Devils open it up 4-1.
Well, how's that for an encore? We just talked about his defensive contributions and how important this penalty kill was. That's Adam Henrique. Well, now he goes on the offensive and makes a great play, strips the puck, goes in on a breakaway. He goes to his forehand. Coro, I think, just got a pad or a skate on it, but nice little play. He stays with it. You see backhand, forehand, great concentration from Adam Henrique, and he's able to flip that puck past Coro, the second shorthanded goal of the night for the New Jersey Devils.
Lobster not trying to step by, and then pivoting to the outside is Marchand, but that right in the path of Backstrom, who laid it on to Oshie, and Ottawa Love shoots. He scores! Thank you.
Well, TJ Oshie finishes off this play, but the pass by Nicholas Backstrom right here, up and over two sticks of the Bruins. Oshie head up, takes a look back, and beats Tuukka Rask, but what a pass by Nicholas Backstrom.
Yeah, great defense by Backstrom leads to better offense by Oshie. At 26 goals last year. That's his 19th this year. The Bruins had numbers going the other way, but Backstrom was positioned defensively perfectly, and Oshie took advantage.
Backstrom has to put that puck probably, what would you say, Doc, 8 inches off the ice, and just up and over, right? I mean, just absolutely.
Blue line, but didn't get it out. 1 second to go on the penalty. Petrangelo to Schwartz, good defensive play. So Rowney moves it ahead of Letang out of the box. He cuts in, he shoots, he scores! Letang does what Cole couldn't do, and he makes it 2-0 Pittsburgh.
Wow. Well, if it wasn't enough for Ian Cole to get a breakaway coming out of the penalty box, Chris Letang. Here's the first look. Cole tried to go short side. That didn't work. Letang comes out of the box. He's got a much better angle. Set up by Carter Rowney, who's going to get an assist here. And Chris Letang goes off the glove of the netminder Allen after the fake. Allen's down off the cuff of the glove. And Allen's deep in his net here, but Chris Letang's got a lot of magic on breakaways. We've seen it in the shootout.
Sidney Crosby now. Spins to the forehand, knocked away. Ferland trying to take off. Dumoulin hustling back. Michael Ferland scores! Michael Ferland steals the puck from Sidney Crosby and makes it 1-0 Calgary.
Wow, a rare turnover from Crosby. He skates immediately to the bench now in disgust with himself. Michael Ferland just poke checks the puck away from here, and that's pretty impressive by Ferland. Crosby can't catch him. And Ferland, in fact, pulls away a little bit, spots something glove side, and with a quick release, he makes it 1-0 from the Flames. But that just tells you how fast a skater Michael Ferland is.
Tangling with Schuster. Knocked free by Garrison. Domestikov, lead pass, Kucherov in behind everybody, hit along, scores!
Kucherov sees Schuster has the puck, he takes off, the risk pays off as Domestikov puts it right on his tape, and then he fires it 5-hole past Peter Budaj for his 20th of the season.
Scoreboard-wise, they were all that big a save, but Anaheim with a couple of unanswered goals. Great pass, gets off on a breakaway as Fowler sends it to him, he ties the game!
What a pass and what a move by the captain, Ryan Getzlaf. They just stunned the Capitals. Getzlaf flying up the middle of the ice.
He was in from center ice.
Watch this strike by Cam Fowler. Picks the head up. Getzlaf splits the D. Watch this move. Fake to the forehand. Holtby wasn't even close to that. Here's the fake. Holtby bites. And then Getzlaf just pushes the puck forward to the forehand side. He's got plenty of room. What a great finish. And all of a sudden, it's the Capitals that are in shock and the Ducks with all the momentum.
Devin Shore and his unit on the ice. Shore has the third power play. Here's a steal by Forsberg. Forsberg coming in shorthanded. On the breakaway.
Stacked up at the line. This is tough to play against. Watch Forsberg. Waiting, biding his time, pounces, and then capitalizes on the other side. Two-thirds the length of the ice, spots the daylight between Lettman's legs, and lets fly. Phillip.
And a takeaway by Hayes, who breaks in and scores! What a play by Kevin Hayes! The steal and the finish, and it's 2-1 Rangers.
Well, he surprised Savard. Savard didn't see him coming. Kevin Hayes anticipated where the play was going, steals the puck, and you talk about patience. Watch 56 get it there. Oh, there's Kevin Hayes, anticipating that, just takes his time, and oh man, what a move. Couple of moves. He got Bobrovsky to open up the legs, and he slid it right between. There it is again. Savard didn't have much of a chance when he got the puck. No chance of seeing Kevin Hayes.
Agri lumbers through the center. Steal made there by Stock. Wenberg ahead here. Bjorkstrand scores. And that's what the Jackets are looking for from Oliver Bjorkstrand. His first of the season in this his sixth game with Columbus.
Absolutely. This kid is so excited to be up here in the National Hockey League and get another opportunity. And a breakaway. He makes no mistake on early in this second period. Great job by Brandon Saad. Neutral zone turnover, and Wenberg, talk about skill. Oliver Bjorkstrand's in a top six role here with the Columbus Blue Jackets and takes advantage. Wenberg gets him that puck, and he goes top shelf on Curtis McAlee. A little pass there, a little 8-foot pass, and there's Bjorkstrand. That's going to feel good.
Jokinen for the Panthers, and now a break back the other way, and they score again. And it's Nick Bjugstad, and it's 2-1.
Another player for the Florida Panthers coming into tonight. Two-game point streak, a goal and assist, and now he stays hot. Beautiful outlet pass up the middle. Bjugstad finds that little soft area right in the middle. D-to-D pass. Ekblad gets his head up, and there's that seam pass through there. A nice spin. Finds Bjugstad, takes a look over the shoulder, and as he's falling down, he finds that nice corner there and picks it. But nice little play, lead pass by Ekblad. And then a nice finish there by Bjugstad. Starting to get hot for the Florida Panthers.
Three goals in just over a minute.
Across for Subban. And Subban lost it to Zucker. Zucker racing in for Minnesota. Zucker scores!
Well, great play here. Blocks a shot. Subban gets himself in a bad situation there. He tried to force a shot through, and it's blocked. And after that, you're not catching this guy. He makes a nifty little play, five hole, and gets the Wild back to a comfortable two-goal lead with 3:19 left. Zucker, a three-point game here.
Down to center, Beaulieu passes ahead and right back to him, and he lost it. That's going to be Armia. Breakaway for Winnipeg. Scores! Joel Armia, near center ice, intercepted a pass. Went in alone and faked Carey Price out of position. It's a tie game.
Well, the sixth shorthanded goal for the Winnipeg Jets, and a good job by Armia. Just sloppy by the Canadians. It looked lackadaisical by Beaulieu, and Armia does a good job on the poke check, and then what a nice inside-out move by himself, and he just buries it into a wide-open net as Carey Price bites on the backhand shift, and then back to the forehand it goes. And no mistake there for Armia. What a big goal for the Winnipeg Jets. As Trouba, who's sitting in the sin bin, shows his love for his teammate there.
That's such a unique skill to look like you are moving lateral.
Here's a pass up ice. It's Marchand in alone to win it. He scores! Brad Marchand, the hero for Boston in overtime. And they'll win it here in San Jose, 2-1.
Another set play of a face-off win. Bergeron able to get it back to Krug. And Marchand's just going to fly the zone. And Krug with that high lob over everybody to allow Marchand to skate into it. And the poise by Marchand with this puck once he settles it down. Caught Pavelski looking offensively. Marchand's able to get behind everybody, just slow everything down. And the poise and the confidence for that little pump fake on the forehand and finish on the backhand. Torrey Krug with the great vision, the soft hands, the set play. Impressive finish by Boston. What a hockey game.
They've had a lot of face-off plays here tonight. Because they win a lot of face-offs, they can make plays. That's one they do. They pull it straight back and anticipate that. Marchand goes in on the breakaway. Nice job of pulling it on the backhand, finding the five hole.
But no score in the game. Castillo is ranted in a breakaway chance and scores! Great poke check, and then a right-flank shot
And the Avs are up 1-0. You gotta love this kid.
Boy, Mike, isn't it fun to watch a young talent like this? Just 20 years old. And, you know, at the start of the season, we've talked about it. The fact that he was coming off a bad ankle, a high ankle sprain, slowed him down. And then first 40, you know.
Did you see who he poke checked away?
Oh, yeah. He poked from my man. Hey, Drew Doughty. I mean, that doesn't get any better than that. But, and then what a shot. What a tremendous shot.
To Minnesota, it was his sixth multi-point game of his career. Granlund's in alone for Minnesota. Granlund scores! He won last night's game on a lone breakaway in overtime. And here it's goal number 21 to tie it for the Wild.
It's a great play by Mikko Koivu. First of all, in defense, right inside the blue line. And then he makes a beautiful little chip pass all the way up to Granlund, who was making a look down the middle. A much clearer path for Granlund this time. Last night's overtime winner, he went through three players and then beat Jonathan Quick. This time he got a little saucer pass from Koivu, but Koivu made two very good defensive plays inside his own blue line.
Works the puck down the boards, finds a bit of room, looking out front. Tip wide, Backlund settles it down. Long pass, could be a breakaway, it is. Brody right in, scores! And the Calgary Flames keep on rolling.
In the offensive zone, Drew Doughty's going to try and set it right up right there. They can't convert, and back come the Flames. And because Doughty was up on the play, he doesn't know that Brody's snuck in behind him. Michael Backlund does. He recognizes it quickly. He goes high back in. Huge victory for the Calgary Flames. Two devastating overtime losses in a row by the LA Kings.
Brody's fifth of the season from Backlund, 147 into overtime. And the Flames have won five in a row.
Paddle on the try from Sagan. Kept in at the line, turned over. Chimera made the play, and here is Ryan Strome alone to the forehand. He scores! Ryan Strome finishes the backhand. The Islanders take a 1-0 lead on the 12th of the season for Strome.
What a save by Thomas Greiss as he's able to extend the paddle on the backhand side on the play for a Sagan attempt. And a just tremendous opportunity. Lindell gets the shot on net. Sagan gets in there. What a save by Thomas Greiss as he extends the paddle, makes the save. Then the Islanders get it out. And they're in play at the blue line. A turnover. And Ryan Strome is going full speed. Little fake. And then he goes five hole and gives the Islanders a quick 1-0.
Going on. Gets by John Moore. Santini is on it. Tries to wind it out of the zone. It gets by Krug. Loose puck gobbled up here. Smith-Pelly walks in. Shorthanded. He scores! Devontae Smith-Pelly just as the penalty was expiring, and the Devils have tied the game. What a swing of events in the last minute 23.
Just a huge turn of fortunes for the New Jersey Devils. Coach's challenge goal overturned, and Devontae Smith-Pelly with good speed, and the puck was stopped by Krug for a moment, but he's able to blow by him as it was slowed down just enough. And Devontae Smith-Pelly makes no mistake. We saw him score a goal very similar fashion. His last goal where he goes backhand, opens up the five hole of the goaltender. This time it's Zadobin, and he puts it in to tie the game up. His fourth goal of the season. That's huge for the Devils.
I had to Gabbert. Remember Lucas Spies? I took that Argila hit earlier. We'll talk about that later. Here's Goldobin in for the Canucks. He scores! Nikolai Goldobin in his Vancouver debut. His first goal of the season. The Canucks lead 4-0.
Boy, there's some speed. You can call him Goldie.
Yeah, how do I describe my play? Just watch me. Well, just watch that. Good play by Nikolai Gogolin, pulling away, bouncing puck. Look at his feet. Separates, gives himself some room. Head up all the way. Ben Bishop backs in quickly. Gogolin reads the play, and he's in. Head up, head up, head up, and snaps it just below the blocker of Ben Bishop.
Andre Palat carries in with speed. Shot it wide as he was being checked by McDonough. Off the boards, McDonough's got it to Zibanejad. He's in. He scores. Mika Zibanejad wins it in overtime. Ranta and Mika Zibanejad.
Tampa nearly won it just seconds before this. Some confusion with the Rangers allowed Palat to get that shot. And when the Rangers came back the other way, it was McDonough to Zibanejad. What a move. He goes from his backhand, and watch how quickly he goes backhand, forehand shot. All in one motion. It had to take a perfect shot to beat one of these goaltenders, and Zibanejad came up with it.
Nice lead to Hayes. Breaks in. Hayes to the net. He scores! Great move by Kevin Hayes, and the Rangers lead 3-0.
And you can add another even strength assist to Brady Shea. There's Shea, look at the pass. And now watch a little stutter step here, a little delay. There, another one, and then he just goes past him. What a move by Kevin Hayes. And it starts with a good pass, and then he just waits and waits and waits until he sees that little bit of room on the far side. There it is again. Little shoulder move, and then a delay. And the just cruises past him and slides it in inside the post.
Near wall by Toby Enstrom, who did not play in that game in Pittsburgh. And now picked up a bit way ahead of the play is Malkin. Behind the defense. Malkin in on Hellebuck. He scores to tie the game at 2. That feels pretty good to Gino. He is on the money against Hellebuck to tie it up.
He's got the goal. He's got the fight. He's an assist away from the Gordie Howe hat trick already.
And he's got his 30th of the year.
Give him 30 onside. Where's Bufflin? Where's Enstrom? He beats Hellebuck short side. What a feed to Gino. And just what the doctor ordered. Wow, how do you get that wide open?
Isn't that incredible? We're talking about Evgeny Malkin, the man that might win the scoring title again this year.
Scoring as well. And out a breakaway for Marchand. He scores! His second of the game. 5-0 Bruins.
It's been a constant theme. Puck management. Anthony Mantha's going to come in. Looking around. Oh, no, he's going to turn it over. Quick strike. Brad Marchand, live legs, pump fake, and just through the wickets. Puck management by Detroit has not been good, and they pay for it again right here.
Just under the right pad of Peter Mrazek. Watch the right pad just bounce a little bit when he moves laterally and just opens up a little. And Marchand finds that hole.
To get across and set.
Here's a break for Pavelski. Shorthanded. In the lounge. Score!
Off, and it's going to end up going back to the point, but Pavelski jumps on Lindell right away. Then he punches the puck in front of him. Watch him get his feet out and box out Lindell.
and then he just goes short side, top corner. Niemi's there. Look at the puck. It's way out in front of him. You got to work on that in practice. He couldn't get the stick to the side of him. Again, the puck's out in front of him. It's going to box out. Way out in front of him. He just kind of snaps it.
White and half. All had it open side of the net.
Here's Hall with another opportunity. In on Mason. Scores! What a move by Hall!
No stick, no problem. The first one snaps in half on the one-time attempt. And Taylor Hall goes to the bench and gets another one. Let's watch this right here. There's the one-timer. The stick snaps in half. Hall goes to the bench. Quickly picks up another one. And watch this as he circles back into the play. And he outbattles Delzato. Goes in all alone in the breakaway. And look at that set of hands. Taylor Hall. Forehand, backhand, one arm, and puts it past Mason, who was sliding to his right. That is a thing of beauty. The Devils take a 4-2 lead as Taylor Hall goes crashing into the boards. You gotta love it.
And then he banks it in off Corey Schneider moments later.
Here comes Adam Henrique walking in, barrels it! Signal on the ice immediately was a goal. The Devils respond. And let's see if Tortorella wants a look at this.
Yeah, we're going to take a look at it, but it may be reviewed or challenged possibly for goaltender interference. Time now for our $1 million replay brought to you by the New Jersey Lottery. Remember, anything can happen in Jersey. Devils just gave up their second shorthanded goal of the first period, but Adam Henrique comes right back, and I think this looks right there. Nice little move from Adam Henrique, and it was put in by the by Josh Anderson on the back check between the five hole of Bobrovsky. So I think this will stand. It looked like the puck was already well on its way in before he crashed the goaltender. Well, tough to look from that angle. It's going to be close. But great overhead look here. Now Josh Anderson tried to sweep the puck away. He put it through Bobrovsky's legs. And just from my vantage point, Mac, let's go to you. It looks like it might stand here.
A stick of stone. Sean Monahan. Gaudreau's behind coverage. There's a pass. Gaudreau scores! Greg, how good have Monahan and Gaudreau been tonight?
Oh, we knew the Gaudreau was dancing in the first period. I mean, it was just play obvious. And there's the pass. What a beauty. And I just can't believe how quickly he got this up over top of Bishop. I mean, Bishop is a huge man. And to get that up over the cross, under the crossbar the way he did. Delay, little backhand shovel. And two goals in 50 seconds to answer that goal that the Kings got late in period number one. What a goal.
Escapes the zone. Campbell turning to allow his team to change lead. Pass. Hossa behind the defense. Stopped by Miller. And the puck went out of play. Did that hit the bar? Or did Miller turn it over the glass?
And Ryan Miller is looking up. Canucks change. What is that? And Mary Hossa is in. It's off the bar.
Sometimes not only making that initial shot, Willie, notice he has steered it out of traffic.
Here comes Arvidsson, swooping in, he scores! Victor Arvidsson keeps it going. Another short-handed goal, his fifth of the season.
Makes it a 7-2 game, as though that required it. And I'll tell you what, this is what Victor Arvidsson does so well. You see him a minimum three times a night. Pucks chipped long out into the neutral zone, perhaps offensive zone. Nobody tracks him down like number 38.
Time.
Blackhawks turn the puck over at the blue line, Pat. The stick by Hedman. Here comes Gord. And beats Scott Darling to the glove side. But the stick by Hedman. And Gord had fresh legs. He had live legs. He had just jumped onto the ice. So he was able to get back. Just a second ever NHL goal for 25-year-old Yanni Gord.
Don't draw a penalty. It shows maybe you're not pushing enough.
Here come the Devils and Taylor Hall, and alone he scores! Oh, what a beautiful move on Hellebuck.
Well, they're pushing tonight as the Devils get two consecutive goals in a short span to take a 2-1 lead, and this is a breakaway on a nice feed from Travis Ajak to Taylor Hall. Nobody's gonna catch the speedster. He goes backhand, forehand, and beats Hellebuck and continues his hot scoring against the Winnipeg Jets. He's had a lot of success. This is a beautiful move. Look at the stride, head up all the way, Taylor Hall. And he goes to the forehand and squeezes it past the right skate of Hellebuck to give the Devils a 2-1 lead.
Puck comes around the wing. Shore to the line. Hemus came in for it, but Pacioretty got it out. And it's Radulov. Breaking in. Oh, Radulov scores! Alexander Radulov snaps a 9-game goalless drought. And it's 4-1.
Radulov was like a man on a mission. Look at the hand-eye coordination, right to the backhand, just where Radulov likes it. He's so good on the backhand, as good as most are on their forehands. It starts from his own zone. Out of a cannon, he just jumps, chips it to the forehand, to the backhand, then goes up and over.
From the same spot as last game against LA.
McDavid will have his opportunities. He drives the net. McDavid, backhand, upstairs, scores! His 28th goal of the season is a shorthanded goal, and the Oilers have a 2-1 lead.
Drake Kajula gets the puck. Deja vu all over again, rings it off the post. And then it goes back in the neutral zone. A lackadaisical change. And there's Connor McDavid. You give that kid that much ice, forget it. It's all over as he walks in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then backhand up high over Jones. A beautiful goal, a shorty that comes at a perfect time for the Oilers.
Takes over the team lead in goals. He's got 28 on the season.
1 minute to go in the third. Now the pass ahead. Here's Eichel with a breakaway. Walking it backhand, he scores! Jack Eichel with a clean cut breakaway, tapped it in, and it's 4-2.
It's going to be Eichel's 24th of this season. Good pressure there by Sam Reinhart. He just feeds the puck forward, and Jack realizes Sam was going to be able to get control of that puck. He started busting down the ice. He skates right into it. He gets Frederik Andersen to open up, and he just slides that puck through the five hole. Makes it look pretty easy.
Drops it. Jonathan Drouin coming in, and he fanned on the shot. Locking it now. A breakaway for Dwight King. King scores! Dwight King finally crowned with his first goal as a member of the Canadiens. And it's a 2-1 game.
What a finish by Dwight King, and I mentioned Learnhout. He's made some good plays. He made the play earlier to break up that rush, which led to the nice stretch pass to Dwight King. As King gets his first goal, his first point as a Montreal Canadian, he goes five hole on Vasilevskiy.
Brownie has come up and been a force. I remember the game he played in St. Louis and continued it on and trying to make a name for himself on this Penguins roster, a veteran who's been around, played in every possible league, a pro league, Steggy, at 27 years of age. So not considered a rookie, true rookie.
Here's a steal by Rowney. Rowney to the goal. Shoots and scores! Right on cue. Carter Rowney gets his third goal of the season in his 27th game in the National Hockey League, and the Penguins have tied the game at two.
Well, we were just singing the accolades of one Carter Rowney, and he gets stick on puck, makes a steal, drives towards the net, turns it from backhand to forehand, and beats Hellberg over the pad and under the glove. Wow, looked like he knew exactly what he was doing, and he did. Really good work. That was a goal scorer's goal. We showed his patience when he scored his first goal ever. He was able to just move slowly to the side and gets a little bit of loving from his teammates there and ties it up at two.
At the point, Beaulieu again holds. Now this time it's broken up by Grabner. Michael Grabner into the break. Grabner in, scores! What a goal by Michael Grabner, and the Rangers have tied the game at one.
Talked about the third Montreal defense pair, Nikita Nesterov and Nathan Beaulieu. This time it's Beaulieu that can't handle the puck, turns it over. You are not catching Michael Grabner. 27 goals in the regular season, 26 at even strength, and he absolutely freezes Carey Price with that fake shot. Grabner, who scored the empty netter in game one, has evened game two. This is a gorgeous move and finish by Grabner.
He had 9 goals the year before, signed by the Rangers as an unrestricted free agent, and might be the best value signing in the league from last summer.
Brent Burns for Pavelski, and he lost control of the puck, and look out, here's a short-handed breakaway. Pass in, step it in, scores!
Goal for Zach Cassian. Great job by him and Patrick Maroon in the box. You love to see this when you're waiting for the guys hoping to kill off a penalty. Good penalty killing with the stick. He takes off, receives it, and just a quick snapshot beats Jones for a 1-0 lead. Cassian's been physical, he's been aggressive, and it pays off with a good chance on the penalty kill. This is an area he's really improved at.
This time the stick check worked for the Blackhawks, and it's scaled back in by Van Riemsdyk and stopped by Rene. Ekholm threw it back, and moving back in with a Zomer check, he scores! Now there is a question being raised. Will it wind up being an offside or not?
Well, he had just jumped on the ice. It aligns him with the look. Safe play. Call on the ice is a goal. Instead of coming short side on Oduya, he tries to reach around, and by that time it goes off the stick of Zolnarchuk, off the shoulder of Crawford, and then into the back of the net.
Deflected back to the boards. Good work there by Foley. Trying to muscle the puck out, and he does, and it's a breakaway. Shorthanded for Backlund. Michael Backlund scores! Backlund shorthanded. Makes it a one-goal game.
Brent Gullison talked about that on the day off in between, that they weren't shooting the puck, weren't trying shorthanded as much as they do. During the regular season, Calgary was absolutely great shorthanded. And here it is. Michael Frolik with a nice pass to Michael Backlund. Head up, head up, head up. Fake backhand, and you can see John Gibson goes for the backhand. Watch Backlund's shoulders. Shoulder, fake backhand. Look at John Gibson. He leans over on that left skate, and Backlund forehand up and over the pad.
First goal of the playoffs for Michael Backlund. The Flames had 8 shorthanded goals in the regular season. And that's a big one for Calgary. Comes at the 18:24 mark and makes it a one-goal game.
Early and late, and Marchand had the latest. Now he's on the puck again, trying to get to that wraparound spot. Shen's got a lead pass, hopping along! Scores! All that action inside the Ottawa line, and then the long clearing pass. And it's 1-0. Ottawa. Hoffman played it beautifully.
What a play here by Carlson. Right over top, high over the
forwards right on the tape. I mean, on the tape of Hoffman, who's been quiet in this series. And he does the old hockey school move. He'll up back with the one hand, completely fools Tuukka Rask and the Senators with the early goal and an unbelievable pass by Carlson.
Couldn't keep it in for very long, and it's the Senators getting it down to Stone. Right in, scores! His first goal. That is so big for him and so big for Ottawa and bigger still for this capacity crowd at Canadian Tire Center.
What a pass by Hoffman here. Bang, stick to stick. Stone gets in behind the defense, finishes it with a beautiful move on Tuukka Rask. And you're right, Bob, it's been a long time coming for Stone. And he's had lots of chances. The coach has been happy with his defensive play, but you can see the relief on his face.
A Donskoy, pull free. McDavid's gonna take off. They're still short-handed. McDavid shoots, scores! Connor McDavid with his first goal of a Stanley Cup playoffs.
What a drive by Connor McDavid. You could just sense it here. As soon as he poked that puck, he looks up, and he's taking this one to the net. Just a good, hard, clean shot.
Sends, get the puck down, and here's a break. Coming in! Score! Fajal so fast, taking off after the puck. Clear break. 2-0, Ottawa.
The second time that the Senators have got behind the defense of the Boston Bruins. 2D, go for the puck carrier. That leaves Pajot wide open. Five hole. 2-0, Senators. The first goal, it was Dominic Moore that let his check go. This time the defense chased the puck. And Pajot head up, picks a spot and catches Rask moving between the legs.
30 seconds into the period.
He looked good on Thursday, looks even better tonight. Does Donskoy, and now here's a break from center ice. Slepyshev in, scores! Anton Slepyshev makes it 2-0 Edmonton.
Wow.
Two breakaway goals in succession for the Edmonton Oilers. And for Anton Slepyshev, he came alive in the overtime period in Game 5 with a couple great chances. It's the pressure once again. A fumble of a puck on the line by Martin. Slepyshev is there, no time and space, and he makes good on the breakaway goal. Has always possessed a good, hard shot. That's why Todd McLellan wanted him back in the lineup, and he makes it 2-0 Oilers.
Todd McLellan sends out Drake Kujula back in the lineup for Edmonton. Just under 4.5 minutes for him in the last game. What a great feed! Up ahead, shot, scores! And just like that, Rickard Rakell has a set play goal for the Ducks.
The warning on the Edmonton bench came a little bit late. Faceoffs have been a key for it for Anaheim thus far. And they win this one cleanly, and again, a set play all the way down the other way. Here comes left side of your screen. You'll see him come right there. Rickard Rakell and his first goal of the series. The little delay, the quick release, and that quickly, the Ducks with a 1-0 lead.
Carlson tumbling down a couple of players, both Daly and Wilson. And back this is in. It's Hornquist in.
There's a different hero every night. Trevor Daly, there's a car crash at one end. Trevor Daly starts out. What a pass by Olli Maatta to Patrick Hornquist.
This is just slick hockey. Moving tape to tape, the stretch pass to Hornquist, right through the defense. Doc talked about Osner usually playing on the left side. He was on the right there. You wonder if that didn't hurt his ability to defend against Hornquist. What a play by the Penguins, 1-0.
Carried out of trouble and cleared ahead by Arvidsson. Here comes Johansson on a breakaway. He scores! Ryan Johansson, 1-0 Predators.
What a fantastic pass from Arvidsson, who's on his backhand. There he is, 38. Watch him flip it up in the air. He took one look up and saw Johansson was there. And there you see the ability of Ryan Johansson as he gives the Predators the lead.
And for the Anaheim Ducks, Brandon Montour was the guy who led the rush for the Ducks' entry into the zone. Unfortunately, he was not covered all that well defensively by Andrew Cogliano, but credit to Arvidsson with that pass as he sailed it over his head, and Ryan Johansson with that long reach is able to create a different angle with that puck off to the glove side and snaps it past John Gibson for the 1-0 lead.
Back to center, spun back across, Dumoulin ahead, and here's Crosby on a breakaway! He scores! Sidney Crosby has tied the game!
Now Brian Dumoulin makes a heady play through the neutral zone, but Crosby with his unbelievable hockey sense sees there's nobody there, there's no resistance. He's going to take off the ice. Roman Josi over-aggressive offensively. And look at the poise, patience, and finish by Crosby.
Here's Ryan Ellis. The puck is in this area here. Ryan Ellis has to realize that his partner's up ice. Turned over, he steps up, and all of a sudden here comes Crosby. Watch the fake shot, and then hold. Patience with the puck, and beats Pecorino with a beautiful backhand. Off the post, off the skate, and in. Talk about patience with the puck. That's how you do it.
Josi jammed it further into Cole, as far as Malkin. A diving play, and it's Arvidsson! Scores!
Side goal from Victor Arvidsson, but two great plays lead to this breakaway. Watch the play by James Neal right here, and watch the play by Fisher right there. And here comes Arvidsson, goes to the glove side, and the Predators lead by two.
They've gone to school on Matt Murray. If you think back to game three where some of the goals went right there, Arvidsson, who has a motor that never quits, out-muscles everybody to the point of attack, along with speed, size, and determination.
Fisher and Neal, the assists at 13:08. Arvidsson tried to play it to the front. Dumoulin got there. Forced back off the boards, and Subban can't catch up to it. Along comes Hagelin, moving on in. He scores! Hagelin with 13.6 to go. And the Penguins celebrate at the bench. They almost clocked their coach, Mike Sullivan, with the stray sticks. Debris comes down on the ice.
Please do not throw anything on the ice. Please do not throw anything on the ice.
Two to nothing in favor of the Penguins on the goal by Carl Hagelin. And the Penguins celebrate what will be the first back-to-back Stanley Cup championships in the salary cap era. The owner and rescuer of the franchise, the coaching staff, celebrating the empty net goal by Carl Hagelin.